Who is that, Shawnee?
Let's try Ricky's best friend. He used to be best friends with Dobo when they was little. You know how they be trying to act like they brothers and shit.
Girl, he is fine. I like to rush that. He go to Washington?
Uh-uh. He go to Crenshaw. Girl, I've seen him before. He work at the Fox Hills Mall.
Do he got a girlfriend?
Yes.
Jamaican girl was scoping on this hoe's man. He fine anyway. You better watch his ass. Somebody might steal.
All right, y'all. Come and get it.
Okay,
girl.
Sorry ass
niggas. Hey, why don't you act like gentlemen and let these ladies eat first?
Yeah, you act like you ain't never had no barbecue before. Let the ladies eat. Hoes gotta eat too.
Wait a minute, nigga. Who you calling a hoe? I ain't no hoe.
Oops. I'm sorry, bitch.
Hey, watch your mouth.
Just playing.
All right, enjoy. And be nice.
No, get out the way. He's still out here.
I shouldn't have left you. Without that gangster music, you get ripped to real. It's bad. I'm bad. It's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you. Without that gangster music, you get ripped to real.
What's wrong with you now?
hey, what a time, my damies. It's the Shoot from the Hip Show with Montoyis and D. Reese. And man, I'm just so preoccupied with this video we got going on. I can't even get to the details of the show, man. Hey, you can catch us at 559-825-7468. That's 559-825-SHOT. Email shootfromthehip1@gmail.com. Everything else, man, go to our website. shootfromthehip.xyz. That's where you get everything. Anything we put out is there. And leave your boy some reviews up in here, man. We see we getting a little, you know, some notoriety, some sharing and whatnot. And we love it, man. Keep it coming.
Yep.
Anyway, dog.
I'm feeling it. I'm feeling the action right here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We got action going on.
That's right.
Yeah, man. Hey, dog. Hey. For real, what's the name of this song? I'm preoccupied. What's the name of it? It's like Tiger and...
Oh, no. You talking about Tiger and YG.
That was YG.
Yeah.
With the whole Mexican thing?
With the mariachi band?
Yeah.
I don't know what it
Dog,
is.
Dog, the video without the music was entertaining.
It is very, it's very entertaining.
I was sucked into it, man.
Yeah.
You know, because I'm going to tell y'all something. I grew up around... not a whole lot of people from Mexico or South America or whatever.
Yeah.
But I grew up around enough of them to get, like, you know, a good glimpse of the way they get down.
They get down.
They get busy. Some of the most rabid Texan fans you ever seen, they masking.
Yeah. They are, man. Dude, I'm telling you.
Yep.
This is a true story. So I went to the Texan game. They played in the playoffs. They actually won that game. They beat the Bengals. That game that J.J. Watt like caught an interception and ran
back. Was that
a
playoff game?
It was a playoff game.
Yeah, I remember that.
I was up there in the cheap seats.
Yeah.
And I went to the restroom, and these guys from Cincinnati are wearing their jerseys anyway. Man, I don't give a fuck. Hey. I mean, whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Like, and them written assignments up, they wasn't going to have that.
Yeah, so them Mexicans were looking at them, mugging them, staring at them. I'm like, nigga, are you serious?
Yeah, it's like that. And every time Dallas and the Texans played, when they had a fight, it was nobody but the Mexicans.
So check this out. So I went back, went to work, talked to one of the older guys at the job. I said, I went to the Texan game. I sat in the 600. I said, man, I had never been up there.
Yeah.
He He said, I already know what happened. He said, ain't nothing but a bunch of drunk Mexicans.
Oh.
I said, oh, he knew too?
Called it.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what, though.
I'm not staying up there for nothing.
Nah.
Not some football.
Not unless you speak the language.
I don't speak it.
You know,
I got Google Translate, though.
Yeah, no. You know, like it, the Google.
Yeah.
You got to ask that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, man, I just want to say that video was entertaining in a bitch.
Yeah.
We did all that just to get back to that, man.
Yeah.
So shout out to
that's the second time we recorded and that video popped up.
Yeah, it is.
And it is very amusing and entertaining when you not listen to the song. We don't know what the song sound like at all.
I do. I recall hearing some of it.
I have never.
And not being very impressed with it. But if you take the sound out,
yeah,
and the video is outstanding.
It is. Oh, they got some eye candy.
They use some good cameras on that thing.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, anyway, man, we ain't going to go too far without the joke.
Go ahead.
Hey, man, what do vegetarian zombies eat?
Vegetarian zombies?
Yeah.
Pussy.
Grains. Badoo-chi.
Knee slapper extraordinaire.
I'll sneak you with one.
There you go. Yeah. We back in business. We drinking some Rodeo Clown IPA and some bourbon whiskey that Texas 1835.
Yeah, man.
So, yeah, I can feel it.
I'm taking it very slow on this here, Bill, man. That's a strong one, dog.
It is very strong. 9.5 on the Richter scale.
Yeah, man. It's like a shot like in a can.
It is. Yeah it is. Hey. So if y'all ever...
If I get sloshy around this bitch, y'all know why.
If y'all familiar with the Carbach brand out here in Texas, man, get some of that double, that Rodeo Clown, that double IPA.
That Rodeo Clown will sit you down.
It will. Yeah. Who did it sit down before? Was it you? We drank the shit up here. Somebody like, damn.
Yeah, that's probably me.
Oh, I think it was you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, man. Beer is supposed to be the step down.
Well, I like beer drink as a chaser as well.
Right. Well, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be like you hit the hard stuff and then you cruise on in with the beer.
Yeah.
Dog, ain't no cruising.
The beer helps stabilize you.
This here, dog. This shit here?
Yeah.
hey, you don't need a shot with this.
You don't. All right. I hope y'all like our intro. Man, that was a little old to The Boys in the Hood. One of the cult classics for black people.
Yeah.
Well, we indulge in gang violence and ignorant
hey,
shit.
Hey, man. Who but you that, calling hoes?
What?
Sorry, bitch.
Yeah.
Hey, when he first did it, the first time I heard that.
Fluh Leon, I don't think that's acceptable.
Oh, does he?
Yeah. He think that's real acceptable.
Well, that ain't cool.
It ain't. I don't believe in it. I don't like calling women bitches.
Yeah, I don't like calling hoes bitches either.
Yeah.
That's low-hanging fruit, Joe. I could do that all day.
Yeah. So, anyway, we back in business. It's the Shoot from the Hip show. You are back in Houston.
Yeah, man. God, dog. So the old lady had to go out of town for work, so she had to go to Austin. And I get home, you know, I'm knowing she's gonna be gone for a couple of days. So I'm sitting in the garage, and in the back of my mind, I'm like, she is not gonna just let me chill in this garage without giving me something to do. It ain't gonna happen.
Facts,
I saw it coming. And I be damn.
Yeah.
I get a call. Did I leave my computer in the room?
Mm.
I go in there and lo and behold.
Now this is the work laptop.
The work laptop.
Right.
Lo and behold, there's a work laptop. Now she in Austin. I'm like, okay, well, I didn't even cut. I just cut right to the chase. Wasn't going to be no finagling or trying to make this shit go where I don't have to do nothing.
Yeah.
I immediately said, I'll bring it to you.
Yeah.
Just cut it, man. Just cut it. And so she hemmed and hawed about it. What about the baby? This and I said, come with me. Whatever.
Did he come with you?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Was that the boy?
Hey, man, he'd been on
road
trips.
On the interstate?
He'd been on road trips already.
Okay.
He just ain't been solo with his old man.
Oh, no, we don't need that,
that
shit.
Yes, we do. That's a different story.
No.
I'd have got him out there.
No, we need his diaper change on time.
Stop that, man. He get his diaper change
He need to
time.
Be wearing shoes.
No, he don't. No.
See?
You don't need no shoes.
Okay.
Anyway, we worked it out, man, with the babysitter and the mother-in-law. And so, shout out there to Austin this morning, man.
Yeah. And you're back.
And I'm back. Round trip, real quick.
Yeah, I text you this morning to find out what time you're coming through.
Yeah. Like, Nick.
Like, Nick. On my way to Austin. I'm like, nigga, what?
Yeah.
What kind of shit is that?
That's craziness, man.
That's fugazi.
She wasn't going to let me just chill.
No.
Without something.
Yeah, well, you just see what I went through. You see how my shit got derailed.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Hey, man, this is a cautionary tale for you cats that ain't married, dog.
Don't get married.
Well, I ain't going to say that, but.
Fuck all that.
Just know that it's going to be some compromises, man. You going to have your mind set one way, and they going to come in and derail that shit.
Got to.
It's part of the deal.
Yeah.
What you got to do.
If my wife told me she was off, you know what I would do? Nothing.
Nothing.
I would never add nothing.
That's right. That's right. It doesn't happen on the other end. They have shit for you to do.
Yeah.
Hey, man, look here. You got to have a contingency plan.
Yeah.
You got to have a contingency.
Hey, and they wonder why, like, we don't let them in our cell phones. They wonder why we don't tell them shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Man, I don't know what's in a woman's nature to fuck your shit up all the time.
No misogynisticness over here.
No, not at all. By the way. All right, so your wife is out of town. When's she coming back? You just found out?
Friday.
Let's get a gunshot for old lady leaving till Friday.
Hey.
I do through this shit all the goddamn time.
Bang.
I do this shit all
it's
the time.
It's bittersweet,
welcome
man.
To my world.
Bittersweet.
Yeah.
You know, I love my wife.
Yeah.
I like to see her at the house.
Yeah.
While I sit in the garage. Now ain't nobody checking me.
Yeah.
I go fly off the handle. No structure.
Yeah.
I need structure, man.
You say you sit in the garage.
Yeah, man.
Mind your own business.
I damn near killed a fifth of Woodford Reserve.
Now, that wasn't the one that I seen. Oh, that Woodford you got on.
Yeah.
Okay. I thought it was that one you left in the bushes when I went to Candytopia.
That's funny. I saw that post, man.
I'm like, man, it wasn't nobody but home team over here.
Candytopia.
And threw the goddamn bottle.
Where was
in
this?
The bushes. Over there off of I-10.
Dog, that wasn't me. I didn't do that.
Man, you did that. Nobody else
I
care.
I thought that was here at your house.
No. Nobody else walk around with no makers mark in their back pocket. But
that's
you.
Hilarious.
We went to Essence, which you was drinking. And which you was walking around drinking. Makers marks.
Yeah. I had a couple things that we
could. Well, yeah. All right. So his wife is out of town. My wife went out of town last weekend. She went out of town with her friends for some type of spiritual getaway, some type of gathering at the Potter's House in Denver, which I didn't know. I thought it was only in Dallas. T.D. Jake.
Okay.
T.D. Jake's daughter has a podcast.
Is that right?
So my wife is all in on this shit. Fuck my shit.
No, that's good.
So anyway, she's all in, and this lady had a meet and greet or spiritual weekend or some type of shit that women do at church in Denver. So her and her friend went.
Denver's a good getaway.
It is. It is very good.
It's the Mile High City, ain't it?
Yeah.
Nothing gets you closer to the Lord than that.
Yeah, I know, right? Oh, man. Yeah. So, she went to Denver and came back. When women read books, watch TV shows. They always come back with some shit.
With some ideas.
Yeah. So anyway, that happened.
We are the work board.
Mm-hmm.
They try all that shit out on us.
Yeah. Well, they come back with a vision board.
That's what I meant to say. Vision board.
She did come back with one. It's downstairs and by the TV.
All right.
So you can check it out on a break.
That's hilarious, man. I just pulled that out.
Y'all beware. If your wife have a vision board, some shit finna change around your house.
Hey, man.
Or as an attempt to change some shit.
Especially behind T.D. Jakes or Joel Osteen or any one of them snake oil salesmen.
Yeah.
You got to watch that, man.
What about that one that was getting on that plane and that woman jumped up on him? You didn't see that?
No, I missed that one. What's that about?
He's a televangelist. He's real rich.
Okay.
And he bought a plane from Tyler Perry. Saleh sent me
Hold on. He bought a plane from Tyler Perry.
Yeah.
Hey, just that little caption right there.
He said that Tyler Perry gave him a good deal on it.
Wow.
Yeah, he need.
Like a G5?
It's a pretty big plane. It's a private jet.
Okay.
But, because they need that to minister to the world.
Yeah. See, the Lord wants them.
Yeah.
To have these vessels.
Yeah. There you go.
So they can spread the gospel.
Yeah.
You know, to the flock.
Yeah.
Somebody turn you to your neighbor and say, they need to spread the gospel to the flock.
Spread the gospel to the flock. Well, come on. Come on. Come on now, Pastor. Hey, now. Hey, you keep preaching that.
Hey, the Lord needs them.
Yeah.
To have a flying vessel.
Speaking of that, so my nephew passed away.
Okay.
So I went to, oh, okay. What the fuck?
I saw the gears turning.
So this lady, I actually recorded the sermon because this lady was hilarious.
Okay. You recorded it?
I did.
Can we play it?
It's not ready.
Okay.
Because you probably have to adjust your game.
You recorded the whole
but
thing?
But what she would do is, before and everything, whenever she got derailed, or like even like if we're doing a show, and then I'll drop the phone number as filler.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I see what you're doing.
Right.
With that.
So she would say, amen, praise God. So whenever would kind of get caught up, tongue twist, say, amen, praise God.
That's the verbal crutch.
Yeah, so watch this. Amen, praise God. She would talk, blah, 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 amen, praise God. Oh, whenever she was stuck, amen, praise God.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
I need me another drink. Amen, praise God.
There you go. That's exactly what she was doing.
I know it.
So I'd be like, 559-825-7468. Take that out and just put in amen, praise God.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
Why are you a student of oration?
So the preaching was actually terrible. I sent my aunt a text like, somebody please take the mic from this woman.
Amen, praise God.
Yeah. Oh, man.
Yeah.
So, it was hilarious. And then behind me, you know, because I believe a lot of church is it's this mythical thing.
Uh-oh.
That
here we go.
Slaves made thinking that life was going to get better.
You think slaves made that?
I think that started from, because no, they would have church back in the day.
Well,
and they would pray and say, man, things are going to get better.
The way
change going to come.
The oppressor put that on them to keep them docile.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, they always thought it's
when
just
I hear people, and as I was sitting there watching this lady preach, somebody behind me, before she could have said, fuck black people, and the lady was already ready.
Ready to say, well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I do know what you said.
I'm like, dude.
Come on.
So part of me was like, first of all, this lady don't. She ain't touching me.
She's just
like
in
that.
A rhythm right now.
She's in a rhythm.
Yeah.
And everybody just getting riled up. And, you know, and she's repeating the same thing. Like, the shit she's repeating is all stuff that will make people say, come on.
Yeah.
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 You know what I'm saying?
Just like when you're riding the beat on a rap song.
Yeah.
Somebody just bobbing their head to it, man. You just going with it.
Yeah.
Don't even know. Don't matter what they're saying, dog.
So when I was younger, I was like, man. How do you go to a white people church?
Well, I've been there.
Okay, but whether you believe in it or not, at least because there's this guy named Charles Stanley that my mother likes.
Okay.
And somebody else told me this. I was at work with this guy. He said, man, Charles Stanley is a great teacher of the Bible. Now, I'm not into Charles Stanley. I don't watch because he does look boring.
Okay.
But he is not on fuck shit. The chanting.
Okay, yeah, see, yeah, there's a certain specific cadence that a lot of pastors use.
Yeah.
And it's funny because anybody
it works for the collection plate, especially.
There must be some science behind it. Because
it is, very
all
much
of
so.
The pastors, I shouldn't say all of them, but you can go to any comedy show and when they're messing with the church, they all mess with that same cadence that these pastors use.
Yeah.
All right. Now, you talking about the white church. Well, I used to spend the night at my boy Nick's house.
Okay. Nick's, is he from the Mo?
Yeah.
Okay.
His stepdad was Catholic.
Where is this guy now?
He's still there.
In the Mo?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
And we used to, if I spent the night over there on a Saturday morning,
uh-huh.
We was going to that Catholic church on a Sunday morning.
Okay.
All right. And so we get over there, and it's real quick.
You might have been in there with your wife and you didn't know it.
Nah.
Was it a black Catholic church?
Nah.
Okay.
No, the black Catholic church is a whole other thing.
All right.
I don't know where y'all from that's listening.
Most people in New Orleans are Catholic, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Well, at least Louisiana as a whole.
Okay.
Yeah. Southern Louisiana for sure.
Yeah.
And my wife's people from southern, you know, southwest Louisiana.
No, nigga. Ville Platte, nigga.
Southwest Louisiana.
If you get that slap your mama seasoning, look on the back and say
Bill Platt. That's all where it's from. All right. So, and they got a black Catholic church down in Fifth Ward, Texas.
Mm-hmm.
Or right outside of Frenchmantown.
Frenchtown.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's a different animal, because it's like they meshing the Baptist church with the Catholic church.
Okay.
That's different. Now, I went to a lily white ass Catholic church.
Back in the day.
Yeah, when I spent the night at my partner house.
Okay.
And dog, that there was bone dry and is seasonless as fried chicken from
now,
a white person.
Think about it. Looking back at it, you probably can't remember the message. Was it good or bad? Or you don't even remember.
Look at man.
Messages, nigga, you wasn't fucked up like you are now.
Church
back in the
messages
day.
Are always the same.
But
what's the? Well, so
did they read directly from the Bible? Though?
Yes,
they did.
They had call and repeat, stand up and sing along, and I say this, then you say that.
Okay,
that type of shit.
Okay,
stand up, kneel.
But
sit
it wasn't
down.
As much BS as the black church.
I wouldn't call it BS. It was bland. It was bland and quick now. Oh, we was only in about 45
That's
minutes.
All you need.
Yeah. Yeah, just like working out at the gym.
Who is this motherfucker?
And what are you watching, man?
Oh, my.
Hey, we need to not have Revolt Channel on, dog.
Nigga,
you
this shit
get,
is the
you
shit.
Get distracted, man.
I do.
We always talking about the church.
The Lord.
That's right.
Delivered.
That nigga good.
If you pay your tithes, your blessing will come times 10.
Hey, man. Look here. And speaking of that. In the mail.
Are you done with your story?
Pretty much, except for this little piece.
Okay.
In the mail, we get a church bill.
Really?
Like, you know, when you first buy
don't
a car
don't pay that bill and see what happens.
And they give you a whole pamphlet of pay slips.
Yeah.
And we get those from the Catholic Church.
Don't pay and see what happens.
Oh, well, we about to see.
No, you don't know. Your wife is paying that
probably,
bill.
Probably.
Yeah, yeah, you goddamn right.
Yeah, that boy got baptized up in there and all of that. So
you owe them.
We honorary members now.
And you got to pay. You got to pay to keep the lights on. You know, they ain't gonna come on for free now.
Hey, man. The Lord said they need light.
Senseless. Steflon Don sent. Oh.
Hey, y'all. We are really flying by the seat of our pants here, because we got.
Hey, was it not worthy?
It was nice looking.
Okay.
It was. But, you know, you react different than me, dog.
Well, you know, hey.
See, I act like I've been there before.
Well.
Hey, you be like,
look here. I'm just being a man. 559-825-7468-855. Shot is the phone number. So I heard we got breath.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
No.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise God. There you go. All
right.
So we got breath?
We got breath.
Not one?
But many times, Taney.
All right, now we still kicking along here. I know we kind of going along here, but anyway, the other day I took my kid to see Spider-Man. It was a bad move.
Okay.
Did you see him sleep, right?
I did. I saw the picture, man. That was hilarious. And he looked just like you.
Yeah, well, guess what? It was not a good idea. now, when the action started, they were all in. But it wasn't a good idea. I thought I was. It was a good test to see where they were. For as like
attention span,
well, just to see what I can, because if I'm going to a movie and I can take them, I'd rather them be with me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, especially my son on a movie like that, and I thought my daughter would be interested in it because Zendaya was in it. But
Zendaya, we just talked about her, didn't we?
I don't know why. I don't know why.
That ain't the one that put the nudes out or something. What?
No.
Oh, okay.
That was no Zendaya. No.
Right.
But she is in that show on Euphoria on HBO.
Okay.
It's supposed to be a hot mess.
Yeah.
Which is true, because, man, kids be doing some crazy stuff.
Yeah.
I remember this dude was doing acid. I'm like, acid? It's just certain shit that I heard certain people do in high school. I'm like, man, I would never fuck with no shit like that. Yeah. Like, it never crossed my mind to sell crack or smoke weed and none of that shit. I remember the boys smoke weed in Woodshop. Mr. Deaver.
They smoking weed. In Woodshop.
Man, Deaver went in that bathroom.
Gutter.
I know y'all not smoking that dope. And I tell you, Deaver looked like, I've seen like every once in a while, Cron.com will post these pictures of old Houston.
Yeah.
Or like restaurants.
Uh-huh.
And you see the good old boy.
Yeah.
Boy, he looked just like it. Whatever he felt, and I don't know, he probably was a good guy,
Man, he was always a good old boy to talk woodshop.
He was a good guy, though, man. And yeah. I felt so bad for him. Man, and whatever. Man, go Deaver. Deaver probably dead right now. But
that's
anyway.
Hilarious,
so I took my kids to see Spider-Man. I thought it was a good gauge of where we are far as the boy and the daddy relationship.
Okay.
He ain't ready for that. Now, I will say when the action started at the end, he's like, no, I don't want to leave. You know, Spider-Man was slinging webs and swinging and shit like that.
Yeah.
He was all in. But the story, the detail, I didn't know that. I thought it's going to be more like the shit on Netflix.
Nah.
With Morales. Now, that shit was dope.
Hey, I bought that.
What?
Yeah, I bought it months ago.
It's on
now. It's on Netflix.
Okay.
When I bought it, man, that was back in like January.
I didn't finish it, but that's a good ass.
Seen it about four times.
Well written, man. That is awesome.
Yeah, and Miles Morales, the Spider Verse.
Oh man, that shit was dope, dude. Yeah, man. That's a nigga.
I bought it.
That's
for the boy.
How cartoons should be, dog.
I bought it for the boy, man.
That was the whole plan. Fire. That shit is fire. So I don't know if y'all watched that, but anyway.
That's because it had hip hop in it.
So,
yeah, we put some soul in that one.
What nigga had on the Air Jordan 1s?
Yeah.
You
understand?
So, the Spider-Man movie, I asked you about it. You said, yeah. And it was,
yeah.
I kind of dozed off myself. I ain't gonna lie. But I ain't take a picture of myself.
You got a history of it. Apparently.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do.
Yep.
I'm known for, I was known for five. But I got to go do, I fell asleep on my wife in the movie. I got to go in the daytime to watch a movie.
Yeah, it's the same thing. As soon as you get in there, it look like nighttime. What's
different? But still, my clock ticks a little different than everybody else. All
right, man.
But anyway.
Lay off that pre-workout, you'd be all right.
You lay off yours, you might be all right.
Shots fired.
My pre-workout ain't never made me bump my head. I might throw up a little bit more.
Man. I need to bump my head every now and again. I'm sorry. That's part of the deal.
Tilt your head down, see if your shit still shaped like a football. Nigga, that ain't low enough.
That's it, dog. It's pretty much gone.
Okay.
It's a little bit there. Man,
was shaped like a Wilson football.
Oh, it was bad. Shit, I should have wore a hat everywhere.
The old lady need to be happy she gone.
Yeah. Before I give her something else to be worried about.
Yeah, I know. But anyway, I had bought this game, Spider-Man.
Mm-hmm.
Nigga, that's Spider-Man. What? Yes, son. That Spider-Man game on PlayStation 4?
Yeah.
Is serious.
Is it? You play?
Hell, nigga.
I saw it. Your boy
I had it for like a week or two. I just opened the shit.
I thought about getting it because I saw some commercials.
It's only like $20 or
$20. No shit.
I got it on Amazon made for $30. But at Best Buy had a sale. They sent me an email. Like
you didn't do Amazon Prime Day with it?
We'll get to that.
I figured we'd get to
that. Nigga. But I opened that shit up last night. Man, I told you, we came home, went to eat.
Yeah.
Old lady went to sleep on my ass. Uh-huh. I told you, I should have fucked with you.
Yeah, because I was out there.
I came in, pumped that bitch up. And I might not play it ever again. But
it was cool, though.
That shit, that's a, nigga, that game is dope, nigga.
Hey.
Bruh, that game is fire. Nigga, if you look at.
So did the movie make you want to go get the game?
I had already had the game.
Oh, okay.
I already had the game. But I was waiting to open it. But after I watched it.
After watching.
I said, let me crank this shit open, man. And it started right. The cinematography and all of that shit. Ooh, nigga, it was dope. Then the gameplay.
Yeah.
I'm talking about, nigga.
Look at you, man.
That shit was
dope.
You're
nerding out. Check you out.
That shit was dope. So anyway, if you don't have that, go ahead and
check
that out.
Look at Reese having a nerd moment, y'all. Hey, y'all hear this dude?
Say, dog, that Spider-Man game is dope.
Did this dude just did this?
It is dope. If you have not played the game, make sure you go check that out. You fucked that PlayStation 4.
Okay, he took. Hey, y'all heard the exhale, right?
All right, so
here you go.
The Montoyis be hating on me, but like I said, it always rain when I want to do some shit.
Oh man, it's not raining now.
It's not, but it came down.
It came down pretty hard, good for about 10-15 minutes.
Now I was on the phone, leaning against the window.
Yeah,
stogie in hand.
Oh, you was already outside.
Yeah, I watched
your
TV.
Fault, man. I believe you speak this into existence.
I watch the TV. But anyway, I got that sausage thrown out. I'm going to grill some chicken here in a minute. But, man, I'm dying to do another brisket.
Yeah, me too, man.
And you pass something up. No. I'm talking about using the store. You don't pass up prime brisket, dog, because that shit don't drop on the shelf often.
I did pass that up, but man, they were a little too proud at that moment.
Nigga, 50 to 60, no more than 60. If it's 60, you good. If it's 50 or 40, nigga, snatch that.
Hey man, well I didn't.
Chill. Fucking with that brisket around this bitch.
Hey, I'm due though. Yeah, you've been trying to get me to do it.
Yeah.
And after I saw my brother do it, I want to do it. I need to slap like 8 racks of ribs on that bitch.
I'm dying to smoke another brisket. I think I undercut myself a lot on my brisket because usually it's always 5.
Yeah. Yeah, you've been pretty A1 with the brisket.
Yeah, so.
Gotta give you that.
But I want to nail it, dog, because my ribs, you know, people always inquiring about my ribs.
Yeah.
My brisket a bad motherfucker, too. It just, I don't do it as much as I used to because so much that it take to do it.
Yeah, it take a lot of time out your day, man.
It does. It take a lot of time. But, boy, you got me wanting to do about an 18-pounder.
I'm there. I got to now.
Yeah.
I got to. I've done it. And my wife
don't never ask for it. But every time I do, she chomping at the bit. Ain't that gonna be ready?
Mine just
she don't want it to rest.
I don't really like barbecue. Then as soon as I pull that thing off, then man, now she making steak brisket taco.
Let her do
with
that.
It and all
I
that.
Appreciate that.
Yeah, well, I appreciate it too. But she act like it don't matter.
It's the BYT. What's up, nigga? Huh?
I had to think about what your code was again. I couldn't remember.
Oh, you got. So you coming through?
Yeah, I'm coming through the gate.
All right. Hey, come on in. We upstairs.
Yeah.
All right, nigga.
Oh, shit.
Hey, you remember the BYT came in this bitch and brought me my beer?
Yeah.
We back. This is Shoot From The Hip Show. The Montoyis, the Reese, the BYT just came in here and fucked most shit up.
Hey, man. We got a lot of damn activity going on around this bitch, man. This ain't no productive show right now.
Man, we winning. We living. We letting the people know how we live out here. It's the Shoot From The Hip Show, and that's how we do it. All right. Your boys out here in H-Town, Texas, giving that hotness. I just talked about how I love to smoke brisket. I'm looking forward to smoking another one. I want a 18-pounder.
Yeah, dog. We do, man. We killed the 8-pound game.
Oh, that's done.
We killed that.
I killed the 12-pound game.
You know, and before I really knew what I was doing, I was killing about the 11, 10.
12.
Yeah, up in there.
Yeah.
So, yes.
Now you got the equipment.
Now I got the equipment.
You want to do some. You want to do some.
Fuck around, do the whole pig and the cow.
Nah, you don't want to fuck no shit like that. Black people don't eat that. We just talked about this. It's certain shit that black people don't do on barbecue.
Yeah.
They really don't do brisket, apparently, according to the article that I read.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah, I do. Okay. It's getting whitewashed.
Yeah.
Barbecue. Yeah, man. Well, we blacking it.
Get off the boob.
We are blackening that thing up, dog.
Yeah.
Square bidding.
All right. So I posted a picture of an empty bottle of Maker's Mark. That was the day I went to Candytopia. Me and my wife took the kids.
Where is Candytopia?
At the Marquee.
Okay.
I-10.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. And what is it? It sound like a candy store.
Okay. So
what it sound like?
Candytopia. Okay. So when you hear Candytopia, what do you think?
Candy store.
All right.
Like the ultimate candy store.
All right. So what I thought was it's going to be a tour of a bunch of rooms, bunch of candy flying and all through the store.
All right.
All it is a bunch of rooms with a lot of with little decor, little candy, and you take nice pictures.
Yeah.
Because all of that shit, it was no candy.
So it's not really a topia then?
It's not. It's a bunch of BS. See, it won't be here long.
See, that's what happened when you oversell and underperform, man.
Pretty much. That's what it was.
That's what happened.
It worked for the kids. I don't ever need to go back.
Hey, let that be a lesson to y'all, man. Whatever you think you're good at, undersell it.
Yeah.
You might mention it, but undersell it.
I will say this. I think you need to take the boy, go and get him some pictures in.
Yeah.
That's all it is a bunch of Instagram pictures and shit.
Here, man.
There's this girl in there, pretty girl, And they had a, she was doing a professional photography shoot for her Instagram page or some shit.
Wow.
You know? I mean.
Dog, I ain't there, man. Like, when the boy can talk, yeah. I want to start taking him
places. Now, you take, because that might not be here. You need to take him now. Get the pictures while you got all that hair that I'm dying to get a hold of.
I don't know. What should we
say? I ain't never cut nobody hair. But boy, if you give me some, I will cut that
man,
shit out.
Man, you got to let that go, man.
My godson had all that hair. Yep. I'm not with that. Man, boys are not supposed to fuck around and have no hair.
Man, that man got like Goku hair.
Man, I'm going to grab a hold of that shit. See, fuck the BYT won't.
He just got out of here.
What's up, BYT, dog? Ruben.
Hey, what's up with your neighbor? What's up with your neighbor across the pond yard, dog?
What they doing?
Letting it go out of control. I mean, it's just really, really hot. Like, they just not.
Was that? That was
pretty. Is it the one straight behind me?
Yeah, straight behind
me. Yeah, they Indian. I'm not sure they big into grass like that. Because my other people that's in front of me are Indian, and they don't give a fuck about their yard that much either.
That ain't racist.
All right. All right, man.
No, BYT
BYT is big on grass.
I know. I asked him when I first moved into the house. I said, man, do you still cut your grass?
Like, yeah.
Yeah. I said, well, good. I'm going to keep cutting mine too then.
Yeah. Hey, BYT ain't playing that shit. He love getting that grass.
That's right.
All right. 559-825-SHOT. Let's get an RIP for Sweet P. Whitaker. Pernell, that is.
Hey, man. Praise God.
Yeah, you go. All right.
Pernell Whitaker.
He was hit by a car. He was hitting an intersection in Virginia.
Who is Pernell?
Sweet P. You never heard of Sweet P. Whitaker? You not big on boxing?
Nah, I really.
He was a good boxer.
I did hear about this recently.
Yeah, he got yesterday. He was hit by a car.
New York with a name Pernell.
Yeah. Well, yeah, he got hit. I didn't
that
know he
nigga
had,
good.
I didn't know he had
shit.
I didn't know he was addicted to cocaine at once. Maybe crack, whatever.
He might not have been addicted.
He won a
Everybody
fight.
Everybody was took, doing it recreationally back then.
Yeah.
They kept it in their.
Mob James did it.
Yeah.
Lord Jamal smoked crack before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
Everybody smoked crack.
That was a wave back then.
If we can get $1 million up, y'all niggas want to donate.
A book of
get
sugar.
$1 million, the Montoyis will smoke some crack.
Man, see. why you got to do that,
you
man?
You said you smoked this shit, dog.
For that kind of paycheck, yeah. I'll take a bump.
Man, I swear to God, I wouldn't let you do it, dog.
Man, come on, dog.
Nigga, that would be the end of your life.
No, it won't.
Nigga, you would not be able to function after that.
Man, are you serious?
If you got $1 million tax-free.
As strong-minded as I am, you think that shit will get me.
You don't. Dude, you see what crack make people do? Crack make men suck
it
another man dick.
Crazy people do crazy shit.
It make you homeless.
It
make you give up on life. You
what about
the
Samuel
side.
L. Jackson? Samuel L. Jackson was on it, and he was functioning on it.
He was.
All right, there's people that functioned on it,
yeah,
and they just got off.
Oh,
of
I
it.
Knew a woman that functioned on crack.
See, I'm talking about there's people out there that did that,
yeah,
and then they let the shit alone when it got too bad,
yeah.
You understand? I'm one of them type of people.
I also do know people that go on crack binges.
Well, see, problem
my boy,
is,
my boy Marcus, he's had his handyman. Yeah. He was a handyman to do some shit. He gave some money. That nigga never came back. Know what he did? He went on a crack binge. It happens, dog. Hey, crack man. Binges are real out here in these streets.
Well, man, I don't ever see myself going on no binges.
Well, you don't see it.
I don't have the mentality for that.
Man, they say that shit make you go search for a high that you could never ever find again.
Yeah, chasing the dragon. I'm familiar.
Yeah. What?
Yeah.
You need to test you right now?
I ain't never chased
okay,
it.
Okay, I'm just saying.
You understand?
Shout out to crack cocaine. All right, this some news. Let's get a gunshot for the news, dog. Shout out to niggas who still smoke crack cocaine.
Yeah.
After knowing what the shit would do.
Shout out to them because we don't even see them no more.
Niggas smoke crack still.
Yeah, they do, but where? We don't see them.
Well, because we fucking got jobs. We live in the burbs.
No, I'm talking about when you just through the city, man. Who's,
every homeless
who's selling it.
Half the motherfuckers you see homeless smoke crack before.
They just crazy.
Man, I would. Nigga, when me and my brother talked for the first time in years. Fluh Leon was there, dog. I was talking to him.
What, Fluh Leon was on that?
No, nigga. But I saw a homeless guy. He asked for some change. So I started asking him. I said,
which
I tried to record
use it.
For? Well, I was asking him. I said, have you ever smoked crack? He's like, oh, yeah, I did it before. I'm like, I know you did it before. Yeah. That's part of being homeless, dog. You,
Oh, that's a prerequisite.
Yeah, you got to try crack cocaine.
You got to get
before.
Off that on that crack, one
man.
Time.
Oh, yeah. So okay. Yeah. Anyway, moving along. Let's go. Let's shoot from the hip show. Get that phone number again. 559-825 self-host 559-825 shot. Make sure you use that. shootfromthehip.xyz is the website.
That's right.
Go ahead and visit that shit. Check that donate button out. Man, might
Amen.
Do some
praise
good for
God.
You. Like, there you go. Amen. Praise God. Listen, you donate to the church, donate to the Shoot from the Hip show.
Amen.
Now, we not a 501c3, but we getting there.
Yeah.
There you go. All right. Trump, he said he wants to investigate Google. What do you want, son? Okay. All right. He wants to investigate Google for working with the Chinese government. Now, Peter Thiel, the Silicon Valley investor, a PayPal co-creator, and Facebook board member says that they are working with the Chinese government. Have you heard about this?
I've heard.
You look real confused right now.
Because, man, Trump ain't. Anyway, man, what I do know is that, you know, Huawei, right?
Right.
The Chinese like phone Cell maker phone. And all yeah. that. Well, the U.S. has released like the sanctions on them. They eased up on where Google and them can work with them a little bit.
Right.
So now they with their back like
I don't know about Huawei.
They backtracking.
So what I think is, I think Trump is using Peter Thiel, and you know, government and politicians, they do a lot of shake hand agreements and stuff like that.
What I do know is that not only the U.S. but a lot of other countries that had dealings with China knew that China was messing up the currency.
China's apparently taking over Africa.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I heard that too.
Okay. Well, yeah, they were doing something where they devalued their exports or some shit like that.
There's a tariff thing going on.
Yeah.
I think China is the U.S.'s biggest competition. So, what Trump has competition, what does he do? He pulls out slick ways to discredit you.
I don't know if it's slick, but, you know, he'll tweet it.
Right. So, Peter Thiel. There are not many conservatives in Silicon Valley in the tech world.
Right.
Well, he's one.
Okay.
And he's the most popular one and the most powerful one. Well, Peter Thiel, he's a Trump loyalist.
And who does he work for?
He does not work. He's PayPal.
Okay, so he's the PayPal guy.
And he's on the board of Facebook.
All right.
So they all.
Well, he's doubly invested in some major stuff.
Yeah, so I think this is a way to affect stock. I think it's a scare tactic. And you know, Trump loyalists, you know, whenever, especially white people and Trump loyalists,
all right,
anytime they hit like Nike,
okay,
they out on Nike. They big Under Armour, because Under Armour is pro police, they pro conservative. People don't know that, but they are.
Man.
But hold on.
I have a hard time believing that Trump loyalists are in these veins of business, like Facebook and all
Peter
that.
Peter Thiel? You don't think Peter Thiel has what is that? What do white people have? I can't remember. You know, I've been drinking.
Lack of melanin.
No, nigga.
Smell like bologna.
The superiority complex.
Okay, I got.
Or to think that they might be losing some ground. Okay. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Well, I don't think that's just a conservative thought, honestly.
Yeah. So, you know, I just think this is a scare tactic. Thiel, he's one of the few conservatives, and I think. What he said was Google won't work with the U.S. military, but they'll work with the Chinese government.
Yeah, that's some old book. Huh?
Now, I do think Facebook and Google need to be regulated better. I think they have so much power.
Well, you know they're having a dust up behind the smart speakers and all that right now, too.
Were they recording us talk?
Yes.
Well, I mean, that's part of it, you know.
Yeah. So, I mean, if Trump and them trying to really go after them, that would be the best way to go get them.
Yeah. And I do think he's coming up for re-election. I think he needs, like, he could say, hey, I won't use my people like Peter Thiel to come after you if you donate or take my side in the next election.
Yeah.
So, I think
Trump getting re-elected, I don't give a damn how it works out.
You don't think Kamala Harris?
Nah.
No?
Mm-mm. Not even. Man, they don't want to see no woman running the country, man.
No.
As much as they preach that shit, they don't want to see that.
Yeah, I want Cleopatra running the country.
Mm-mm. Cleopatra, really? Is that what they call a Kamala?
No, I made that up. But what I'm saying is, she's a Cleopatra was like a feminist. She had like sex slaves, men sex slaves, didn't she?
Uh huh.
Yeah.
That's cool.
But I'm just saying.
I don't really know, because do we believe that story about Cleopatra?
I do.
You do?
Because she was African.
Well, she was Egyptian.
Nigga, that's African.
It ain't the same.
Okay.
Come on, man. All right. You see the Egyptian, you won't think Nigeria.
Let's talk more about women on Shoot from the Hip Show. So Trump insulted four women with a racist, xenophobic tweet.
That's right.
He attacked four Democratic women, all minorities. Trump said they should go back to their country.
He never said their names.
Yeah. Well, we know who he's talking about. One GOP lawmaker said the comments were unbecoming of a world leader. These are Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, Ilhan Omar, Rashida, Tlaib, but I don't know how you say his
name. That's probably right.
Ayanna Pressley. Three of these
I know
women,
Ayanna was black.
Yeah. Three were born here. All are American senators. They are all elected
by
American voters. Now, Lindsey Graham, you don't know who Lindsey Graham is.
I do.
He's very vocal. He gets very emotional when he's in front of a microphone. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, he has a lot of videos up there where he's opposed to Trump.
Yeah.
Now he's supporting Trump.
Yeah.
He's a good golfer. Yeah. They played golf the other day.
Yeah. Okay. He's the best golfer.
Yeah.
You are. He spoke directly to the camera and said, "You are the best golfer."
Yeah.
Just licking his booty.
Yeah. Just
all
like,
out there.
Just like, what's the guy here? What's our governor? Or what's our state representative?
Cruz.
Guy insulted his wife.
Yeah.
Yeah, Cruz.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
that's
whatever.
Crazy,
these
man.
Motherfuckers so
that's
lame.
Funny how politics work, man.
So the GOP as a whole doesn't agree with his comments, but they won't call him a racist.
Bet not, because they'll be fired.
All right, so I believe that the comments are racist. I think there are certain trigger words in there that white people look for.
Fucking right.
Yeah, I think he's what you would call sunning them. Go back to
he
your country.
He was sunning them?
Well, go back to your country.
Yeah. He wasn't even really talking to them.
No.
He was talking to the people that like him.
No.
He was telling them
because they are not. They're
he
not.
He just wanted his constituents
no,
to see that.
They're not white.
He didn't say them, their names or nothing.
No, listen. That is a sign of ownership.
Oh.
Okay. Meaning, because white people believe that America is there. They believe they founded this country.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
They.
All right, Malcolm.
I'm just telling you. They didn't land no Plymouth Rock.
Hey.
You know, I told you I said that in the play.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
All right. Just,
and it's coming back, apparently.
Yeah. So you
Montoyis and Malcolm on the Shoot from the
Hip
Show.
So you don't think those comments are racist?
I think they were poignant. Racist is the easy. That's the low hanging fruit of this thing.
No, but that's what it was.
But I think that he was just trying to say something to get his constituents and his followers riled up.
You don't think he believed that?
I don't think he meant that shit.
Really?
No.
So a lot of times people say stuff.
I think Trump talks out his ass all the time.
But again,
I don't think he believes half the shit he says.
You know that? You ever heard that saying that people say what they really mean when they kind of inebriated or drunk?
Yeah.
So you don't feel like he always walk around with this high feeling like I'm the president?
I think
so. He's emotionally high.
He's narcissistic.
Yeah.
I think anything so he says to big himself up, I think he does that.
Yeah.
But
hey, come
I
on.
Think he think he's better than a lot of white people. I don't think it's just all like a racist thing.
I think so.
I think he looks down on white people too.
Well, yeah. He know who ain't shit.
Hey, that's my point.
Yeah.
So I don't think it's
that's
just
a BYT.
I don't
point.
Think it's a whole racist bit. I think he's just, I'm Trump and you're not me, and that's it.
All right.
That's what I think.
Talking land here on the Shoot from the Hip Show.
All right,
because we all want our 40 acres and a mule.
Uh-huh. And we 50 minutes in.
It's all good, baby.
All right, man.
Area 51.
Yeah, man, what the hell, man?
Okay, hold on. So
I've been seeing this shit everywhere.
Air Force training range.
Right.
So apparently on September the 20th from 3 a.m. to 6 p.m. Pacific time, 1.5 million have signed this petition. They're going to charge Area 51. They are going to run in there. Now, the Air Force claims they will defend the area.
Yeah. Tread carefully. We had to fuck around. Had some.
So Jackson Barnes, or the Twitter account named Jackson Barnes, he drew up a game plan. What it looks like.
She was sticking her tongue. I just smoked that shit. Anyway, my fault.
What it looks like, that's 21.
Yeah, it's 21. We looking at the video. I got sidetracked.
Live from
y'all.
England.
I got sidetracked.
She looked London, no. She looked like she from England. She look like a Brit.
Yeah, anytime you see the chick stick a tongue out, dog, that's thought move right there. You know what you got there.
Alright.
I've seen it too many times, man.
So he drew up a game plan. He posted Area 21. And then it looks like what he has is whatever your zodiac sign is, you pick a certain area and then y'all gonna
they can't stop us all. I saw that part.
Yeah, so.
Hey, come on, man.
Hey, would you go?
Hell no. I'm not fucking with that.
Nope.
It's something up, dog.
Come on,
and
man.
It's a reason it's been this quarantine that long. And now the Air Force is threatening to?
Yeah.
There's some shit there. I don't want to know what it is.
Well,
screw that. That's where they faked the moon landing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, you know, a lot of people don't believe that nobody ever landed on the moon.
I know, man.
Well, so there is apparently they, people believe there are aliens there and a lot of extraterrestrial technology. Mm-hmm.
I buy it. I don't know what's there, but you can just name anything. I'll be like, yeah, that's probably there.
The drinks do be a little strong in Vegas.
Hey. And people tend to, you know, they have inhibitions. Drink or not, just naturally when you're around that area,
yeah,
your inhibitions lower.
Hey, did we
you start about, acting stupid.
Did we talk about ASAP Rocky last time?
I think we did.
We did?
Maybe not. About him being... No, because we mentioned it on social media.
We didn't talk about it on the show.
No, we did.
All right, before we talk about him, let's talk about R. Kelly. He was arrested on federal charges. He's going to remain jail with no bond on child pornography charges. He's accused of paying thousands of dollars to recover sex tape of having sex with teenage girls. They say, now, is it 14 or 18?
What's that?
A 19.
The ages?
Yeah. They didn't say.
I think it ranges.
All right. So he's facing one count of conspiracy to receive child pornography, two counts of receiving child pornography, four counts of producing child pornography, five counts of enticing a minor to engage in criminal sexual activity, and one count of conspiracy to obstruct justice. And I think that's from sending the family of the other girl on the trip. Wife trial.
Hey man,
how old is that girl now?
I don't know, but you can't blame her for trying. Hey, here's a trip.
Well, they gonna throw 1,000 charges, see it one stick, but know
that's what they did with old Jussie.
So he's done. He's gonna die in jail.
I don't think they gonna get it, man.
Come on, man.
They gonna
can you
get
imagine
it.
The next life with Cosby and R. Kelly?
I know,
like
right?
Two.
Yeah, that that would be hilarious. You know, it's funny you said that about life, because I've been on Instagram.
Yeah.
And they're having this face age challenge thing.
Ah, yeah.
You been seeing that?
I've been seeing it.
Hey, I downloaded the app last night.
So did I.
I took a picture of myself.
So did I.
And I deleted that shit.
I did too. That shit. My nigga, I look like I'm 90 years old.
Hey.
All them other people... Nigga, fuck that.
Screw that shit.
Yeah. And I didn't post my shit.
And then what I saw also on Instagram was that somebody posted a picture of Eddie Murphy from the movie Life.
Yeah.
As an old person.
Okay.
And he's like, my timeline look like this right now. A bunch of people with their old pictures up.
Yeah.
I mean, it's funny.
It is.
I'm not participating in that shit.
Nigga,
man.
That shit look
fuck
terrible.
That.
Yeah.
So the government know what we look like when we 50 now? Or
yeah.
70? Screw that. I'm going to go into anonymity.
There you go.
You ain't going to get an app challenge to get me out there.
Yeah.
I suggest y'all take y'all shit down ASAP.
Nah.
Fuck that.
That's the world we live in. Google's tracking everything.
Hey, you know when you downloaded that app, what did it ask you? I want permission to record all your videos and have access
well,
to
your apparently
pics.
You're supposed to delete it soon because it'll start charging you, I think.
Well, whatever. Every app, or I shouldn't say every app, but a lot of apps, all they want is access to all the shit in your phone. All your files, your photos, your contacts. Hey, screw that shit. Don't do it. Y'all better start just not saying yes to all this shit, man. Allow. No. Deny.
Access denied.
That's right.
All right. 559-825 self-which 559-825 shot. This is Shoot From The Hip Show. You got D Montoya, you got D Reese, and Nolan is opening the door every once in a while to fucking irritate his daddy.
Featuring.
Or, you know, what do you want? You always say that in and out. What do you want? All right. This is Shoot From The Hit Show. We're going to take a quick break.
Yeah.
We'll come back with Fliggity's phone calls.
I don't know who you just said. I know Fluh Leon called.
All right, this is Shoot from the Hip Show.
Yeah.
What?
Huh? You ain't got to be creeping. I don't know why you trying to act like you cleaning up. Man, I always think we're going to steal something.
You know what you want, dog?
Go ahead and give me that O.E.
Yeah. I'm going to fuck up some of this ice.
Oh, no, boy. Oh, man, I'm from the old school, brother.
Yeah. You not to drink beer in store.
Hey, man, I'm going to pay you. Hey, look, bitch, stop following me around this motherfucker. You getting on my nerves.
You hurry up and buy.
Shut the fuck up, man.
Just pay and leave.
Hey, man, I said I'm going to pay you. Won't you calm your motherfucking nerves?
Damn. Hurry up and go.
Hey, man, won't you go ahead and get me? Shh.
I got your back.
Won't you get my change? And won't you give my homeboy his change?
I don't want any trouble. Just get out.
Can't stand y'all.
I feel sorry for your mother.
What you say about my mama? You feel sorry for who?
I don't want any trouble. Just get out.
The fuck you say about my mama?
I don't want any trouble. Just get out.
You talking shit. How many times I come to this motherfucker? You got something to say. Hey, where the motherfucking videotape? Give me the motherfucking videotape. Give me the motherfucking videotape right now. Hey, nigga. Hey, clean the cash register. Come on. Shut up. Shut the fuck up with that noise. You to open a damn register.
Damn,
nigga. Open this shit. What the f- six motherfucking dollars, nigga?
I know y'all got some money in this motherfucker somewhere. This don't even make no damn sense, man. Let's
fucking
just go.
Change. You got a damn radio killer.
Stop!
I'm gonna kick your shit too.
Fuck!
Jackpot. Hell yeah. Gang of this money, nigga.
Forgot about that, didn't you?
I did forget about that. You know what's most jarring about that movie?
What's that?
Was the next movie he did. Lorenz Tate.
Oh, Lorenz. Oh,
The Inkwell.
The Inkwell's a dope. That's a classic.
It's
man.
A dope movie, except that it's so far a departure from
Old Dog.
It fell flat the first time I saw it.
That's a tight ass movie, dog. Man. That is a feel good movie. Me and
it is. Except
me and my wife might watch that movie.
Well, when I saw it, I saw Old Dog acting like a bitch.
That's a good actor.
Yeah, well, still, man, in my juvenile mind, I was like, wait, no, you gotta ease us into this.
Your mind a little juvenile?
When I was a juvenile, when
oh,
I came out.
Okay. Oh, yeah.
What you doing, dog? What,
I'm just saying.
Sound like you try to, you sonning me, dog?
No, so I wouldn't son you. Wait. No, Humvee gets sonned by DJ.
You think you're
DJ.
Better than me?
Matter of fact, while we doing this, shout out to the truck cast. Make sure if y'all in a relationship and stuff like that, make sure y'all.
I don't know, man. I think
you
just think you're better than me.
Nah.
Shout out to the truck cast. They went live last night, and I jumped on now.
Did you?
Yeah.
Did you learn something?
On the shows thing. Not really.
I mean, because you've been through a lot of it.
I'm so far past learning about relationships.
Yeah.
I just know what I know at this point.
Nigga, I'm just trying to find the thruples. Because I had a conversation with somebody about a thruple.
Man, look here, dog. You
walking well, there's a difference. There's polygamy and there's thruple. I think polygamy is you just have a stable. Thruple means you get to fuck everybody and y'all get to enjoy each
thruple
other.
Thruple is you get to fuck two of them.
Yeah.
That's not everybody.
That's gutter.
No, it's not.
That's what I'm talking
about. Because the other shit comes in.
Hashtag thruple.
The other shit always comes in, man. What I know about women is this. None of them want to be number two.
Well.
None of them want to be number two. They'll play that part for a minute.
Yeah.
But it ain't going to last that long. Well, either they're going to get tired of that and leave you alone.
Yeah.
Or they're going to get tired of that and fuck up the number one shit.
Well, what I think most women should do is look in the mirror and look at your potential. And just think, just look at your potential, not only your looks, think about what you have to offer. Mm-hmm. If you can't cook, if you come from a bad family, mm-hmm. You know, if you're not good in bed, mm-hmm. like if your pussy don't get real moist, mm-hmm. I tell you, there's moist and there's moisture.
Yeah.
I'm talking about that. Hey, listen. When your shit get, hey, when your shit get so wet, that nigga gotta pull his dick out.
Yeah.
You know, or like, when your shit gets so wet that you leave a stain in the sheet because it didn't drip.
That snail trail. Yeah.
The X-rated show about. That it is the Shoot From The Hip show. 559-825-7468-559-825-SHOT is the phone number. This is the Shoot From The Hip show. The website is shootfromthehip.xyz.
That's where you get everything.
Everything.
We do.
There's a donate button. As I look, it says Visa, MasterCard. There's a red
PayPal.
And blue. American Express and Discover. I guess we take all of that action.
Yeah, man. If you're feeling guilty about all this enjoyment you get, say you're on a long trip.
Yeah.
And you
to
need,
Austin.
And you need
and back.
Say that again.
Yeah.
And you need something to listen to. Guess who you got?
Yeah.
You got your boys over here from the Shoot From The Hip show.
You got us.
And we got plenty of content out there.
We do. We got breath?
Yeah, we got breath. Not one.
But many times.
But tiny. Many times tiny.
All right. So we got many times tiny with the breath. We're going to go ahead and get it out. Let's go with the first one, then we'll work in the fuckery.
Yeah, because I think we need to work these through instead of just listening to them straight. Because this man here.
Signing off on Instagram Live, man.
This man here is loquacious, as I like to say.
Just a little loquacious.
A little bit. Loquacious and a little quirky.
Shout out to Be Honest. I didn't know he fuck with us on Instagram.
Yeah. He really don't be on there like that. That's surprising, actually.
Well, that's a Shoot From The Hip show, man. What you expect, bitch?
Hey, man, because we gets down like that.
Already.
All right, man. This one here come from the 281. All right. Let's see what it do.
Hey, man. It's your boy, Fluh Leon with the Skelly. Real quick, shout out to all my Shoot From The Hip fan, man. Got a joke of the day.
Awesome.
What do you get from D. Reese when DJ asks him to show off his superb basketball acumen by way of analysis? Not a goddamn thing. The doom ching. But I'll get back to that here shortly. First things first, D. Montoyis. You seem to get a little flabbergasted by the Rocks for a Rupert thing. Your ass worse than Trump in them, nigga. It's an inside joke, bro. I done told your ass about sticking your nose in family business, man. By the way,
I thought I was dead, bro.
You know I love you like a second cousin, man. And I'm coming from a safe place. When I say this, man, hear me out, man. It may be time to start talking intervention, my brother. You got Ayana. You got Dr. Phil, you got hell, even the lady from Get Out, nigga, you know what I mean? It's not a good look, bro. It's not a good look following your head and shit. Secondly, to the hot topic of the day, cannabis oil. Holistic cannabis oil. Wow, shit worked wonders, my nigga. There's not much more to say about it. I mean, old Dale and Miss Keisha, they pretty much gave an accurate assessment of it. I mean, you two Kendrick Spears, man, can be real douchebags at times, man. And the Montoyis, man, I'm surprised by your disposition on it, because your ass got a natural high look all the motherfucking time, man. So I'm surprised by that. But while y'all ass was doing curmudgeons, total curmudgeons, you totally missed the point about the young lady when she said the CBD oil is a great benefit to the well-being of a daughter's health, man. And to make it personable, D. Reese, man, my baby, your niece, you know her health challenges, man. Guess what? We found out, man. Guess what we found, bro? We've seen a great improvement thanks to going the holistic route, man. So you might want to consider some things. I mean, it's pretty much a perfect alternate solution to it beats opioids, I'll say that. I challenge you niggas to do your homework on it, man. I think where it went wrong is when it became kind of like commercialized. Anytime you walk into a corner store and you see CBD next to the tall tees and the A-Sound hat, game over, man. Game over. Mm-hmm. It's a wrap on that shit. But I will say this, though. I'm never...
Yeah, he will say nothing right now because he got cut off.
All
right. Sound like he might have been on some CBD.
Probably so.
Hey, well, there it is, man.
I rub some on my dick.
Hey, man, hey.
If it don't help my stroke game.
You fuck it all night.
Man, I went to buy some energy drink one time. I got some shit called Nitro.
Yeah.
Nigga walked in, that shit had you fucking all night.
Hey, man.
All right, nigga, shut the fuck up.
You know, people say that about a lot of shit.
They do.
You know, I remember when I first started drinking, they said, man, you get off that hen. Man, you be fucking all night.
Yeah, like it's been scientifically studied that drinking Hennessy gonna make your stroke game like right. tight.
Right.
So what did you hear? What is his inside jokes?
I don't know. I think the root pour was the inside joke.
Okay.
When he called it the rocks pour. And oh. I had too much fun with that.
Oh, yeah.
Now
yeah.
see, I always try to respect this man. When he told me I couldn't call him Fliggity, I stepped the fuck off of that and got off of that. Right?
Yeah.
You know, I make it a point. Even if I'm not on the microphone, I'm like, nah, not saying it.
Yeah.
Not saying it. That's Fluh Leon.
That's Fluh Leon.
That's it. But he still, goddamn, man, when does it stop, though?
Hey, man.
Like, if you do love me like a second cousin, that sounds like family.
Yeah.
So eventually, dog.
I mean, you can call him Fliggy.
Shit. Something. I come up with something.
Now, he said intervention.
That's about me falling on my head.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you know, there is some Flig validity to that.
Yeah.
Actually.
You think you need intervention?
No, but that needed to happen.
Really?
You slowed me the fuck up a little bit.
Really?
Yeah.
I can't tell.
Well, shit. Like, if I'm sitting at the crib, I'm good.
Goo-wop.
But if I'm out there in the world,
no.
Nah, I'm chilling on that shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah, that happened. That was the intervention I needed, was a bump on the head. See, I believe most people need is some physical retribution for your action.
Yeah.
If you're fucking up, you need something physical to be like, hey, you fucked up.
Yeah.
Bam.
So you at home, you can go hard as you want.
Fucking right.
So now you know. When you're not at home, to hold back.
They're damn right.
So does that mean beer only?
Well, I might take a shot. Not much more than that.
Yeah. So yeah. What did you do differently when you was at with Grizzly?
Man, I was going hard, man.
You was?
Hell yeah.
Like, you was going hard before you left the house, though. That's what I don't understand. I told you. I said, dog.
Yeah, you
stop
did say
now.
Yeah, but I wasn't there at the house.
Nigga, you was there.
I was close.
No, nigga. I trust me.
I remember.
You can tell. I can tell.
I know what you mean.
Yeah, I can tell by mannerisms and in your actions.
You're a friend of mine. I know what you mean.
Yeah.
But when I got there,
yeah,
it was a different level.
Yeah. Well, you called me. Do you remember calling me?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I told you it was going down.
You was coherent then.
I said, hey, nigga.
Nigga.
Yeah. So, man, I needed to do that for myself.
All right.
I'm just glad I had stand-up people around me.
So, you don't think no... You think you got this under control as you drink it?
As I take a sip. Hey, man, look here, man. I'm not one to hide from my faults.
Yeah.
You understand?
Yeah.
And when I know I done fucked up,
yeah,
I stand up to it. I did that. I fucked up.
Man, I tell you what, man. I had several times where I threw up in the arm and I'm like, never again.
It happens.
But you know, as you get older, man, it's like you just tolerate more. I remember
that's
when,
part of it.
I remember when I used to better consume a lot.
Yeah.
And I'm like, damn, nigga. Like, man, I drink a lot and I'm good. I said, man, that's not good.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I'm like, man, let me stop.
Yeah.
Let's go hard.
Oh, I believe it.
I went hard last week. I was going hard.
You came to my house one time, you was there, and I said, and I wasn't. And the shoe was on the other foot. And I said, oh, home. Look at it. I tried to catch up, but I couldn't. And I was like, this nigga's far gone.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we enjoyed it. It was all straight.
All straight. All right. This is the fuckery segment of the show. We got more voicemails.
Are you finished with his voicemail?
Is there something that I missed?
Well, he went into the CBD thing.
Okay. So CBD, I don't agree with at all. I don't fuck with that shit. Anything that's similar to recreational drugs, I don't fuck with.
He said he had a breakthrough.
Yeah, so my niece has some issues, but apparently he says I didn't know.
He said the holistic thing is working.
Well, that's fine. But I don't fuck with it.
Okay.
I'm not fucking with that shit. And if that's the deal, then it's just a deal. And you should have told me that instead of calling the voicemail line.
Hey.
You should have talked to me on some gutter shit than talking to me on the show.
But we all family, though.
Right.
So, you know, come on.
So, anyway.
That's why I can't call.
I will hold my reservations on the CBD oil. But it sounds like some fun shit to do right now. It sounds like an easy way to get around the police. And keep getting fucked up.
Maybe I can call him Fligger CBD.
There you go.
I'll work that in there some kind of way.
Yeah.
Poking my nose in the fatty business.
I'm telling you, I'm rubbing that shit on my dick one day.
All right, man. Well, don't you get her fucked up. Or you fucked up.
Yeah.
At least let all the parties know.
Yeah.
You know?
Shit. Where do you buy this shit at?
Man, at the corner store, they got it right at the damn next to the extension.
By the tall tees.
By the goddamn horny goat weed.
Okay. let's talk Big Baller Brand.
Okay.
All right, Big Baller Brand was on sale at the local gym. Apparently, the shirts were on sale for $5.
Man, this show finna run long in a bit.
So the Big Baller Brand, it was on sale at a local gym during volleyball tournament. The Big Baller Brand, as you know, has received a felon grade from the real BBB, which is the Better Business Bureau.
They should.
They struggled with sales, couldn't honor delivery times. So the clearance sale was a everything must go. $100 could get you entire get up, including the shoes.
That shit gonna be in Kmart.
Now you know Lonzo turned down offers from Adidas and Nike, which was, you know, I would imagine those deals could he was a top five. He was a lottery pick for sure, but a top five, maybe even top two. And he could have got a million.
Now it's all gone.
Now it's all gone.
All
fucking
gone
with his daddy.
BBB.
Well, fucking with his daddy.
Yeah. Well, we all saw the train wreck. We saw it coming. We didn't see the after effect.
Not everybody. Some people thought that this dude was on some shit.
I don't believe that.
I never thought he was on
some shit. I think the idea of what he was trying to do was noble. I think people saw the idea name, like owning your own shit.
The name in itself was idiotic.
Yeah, okay.
But Big Baller Brand.
I'm just talking about owning your own shit. I think
come on, man.
People saw that part and was like, okay, I see what you're doing.
Yeah.
But at the same time, we see this buffoon.
A buffoon.
Yeah. Buffoon Baller Brand.
Yeah.
We saw that shit happening. Yeah. So we're like, that shit ain't going to take off with them. I don't know if buffoon is the right word.
Oh, he's a buffoon.
Because apparently, I mean, they living okay.
Yeah, they living off Lonzo's.
Well.
Now, I do think the younger son is going to be better than Lonzo.
We have yet to see it.
Well, he's in Australia. He signed up to play in Australia.
Yeah, well, how is that going to work then? Is Australia paying dividends?
No, that's just a buffer to get him to the NBA.
That's
without
not
playing
a knife.
Because he can't play college ball because he's ineligible because of his daddy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. 559-825 cell phone, 559-825 shot is the voicemail
phone line.
Praise God. Amen. There you go. Amen.
Praise God.
Amen. Yeah, praise God. So, Fliggity had Mo to get off his chest because his last shit got cut short.
You said it. I didn't because I ain't poking my nose.
All right,
family business.
No, he said you like family.
Yeah.
That's kind of like.
After he chastised me for enjoying the RuPaul thing too much.
Roxpaw.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I'm not saying that no more. But I'm going to tell you this.
You don't understand the validity behind the Roxpaw thing. He was serious.
I bet he was. But I'm going to tell you this.
I went to Roxpaw the other day.
I
came to your house afterwards.
Yeah.
That was like last Friday.
That's when you was on it.
Yeah.
And that's when I was like, man, home team over here.
Hey, man, I was out here living, baby. Shit.
Yeah. But hey, man. Hey, Fluh Leon, I'm cool, dog. I love you like a cousin, too. And so I'm going to let you push me around a little bit on these words I can't say.
Hey, that sounds like a swim challenge.
I'm going to. See, I wasn't even going to bring that up. All I'm saying is I'm going to allow you to push me around a little bit because I'm cool with that.
Yeah.
But nigga, them jokes gonna come sooner or later, dog. And as soon as I feel like it's time to unleash, dog, you gonna get them jokes, man.
Yeah.
You gonna get them.
Already.
That's just part of the deal. But all right, man, let's listen to this next one coming from the, not the Fliggity, but the Fluh Leon. Here you go.
Fluh Leon with the Scully on. Take motherfucking two. That's that bullshit I be talking about, man. I told you, man. That shit makes no sense. I could have did this shit in one take and done with it. But it's all good, man. I'm catching up on some shows, man. And I have some shit to say, man. So here it is. I'm going to wrap this thing up real quick. Like I was saying, I'll say this, man. I never heard anyone gone off the CBD oil or the marijuana and causing any accidents or even busting their head trying to get out the Uber for that matter, man.
Oh, shit.
I'm just saying. So my final thought, man, let me address the joke of the day, man. I have to show some love and commend my man old DJ on this one. That move was genius. Like,
what?
For all my chess players, it was pretty much checkmate, man. D Reese, your motherfucking, you're my bro and I love you, man, but you always talking shit. And you always talking about flaming somebody, man. Well, your ass got yoga flamed on this one, motherfucker. He hits you with the motherfucking Mario Brothers fire spit on that. You know what I'm talking about? He's fighting King Cooper, that motherfucker.
He hit
you in the weak spot, man.
Who?
He got you on that one, man.
I'm talking about DJ. What did he give me?
Without him being in the studio and how he presented it, you couldn't just be demonstrous and over talk a motherfucker with a vague commentary and generalization. I mean, he actually has one motherfucking question, man. And you fumbled that motherfucker, man. All your motherfucking ass had to say is, hey, Toronto won, because in that very moment, DJ, remember when I say this, they were a better team. Everything went well.
That's what I said.
I mean, throughout the history of the NBA, every championship team, with the exception of maybe like some Spurs or some Bulls team, but every championship team, everything went right. And everything went right for those guys, man. The big shot, Kawhi played out his fucking mind. They were just a better team, man. And if I had more time, I could really break it down. But Reese,
yeah,
you dropped the motherfucking ball, and I got one last goddamn thing to say.
Uh-oh.
Montoyis, I need to check up on you. At the Reese, you oversold and underperformed. One more time, D. Montoyis, let me hey. Eat that. You oversold and underperformed.
I just said this, yeah.
Talk all that shit about, see, DJ was smart, because you talked all that shit about how well you know the game over this guy. I mean, I know your weakness, you know what I'm saying? But I wasn't going to never expose you. You know what I'm saying? If he can't be there with you and you overtalk the nigga, it ain't going to work for you. So he caught you off guard and you
and it cut him off again.
Where did he start? Let's start with the beginning of it.
Okay, let me scroll up here. I feel like it was another shot at me up in there.
It was.
Yeah, shit. Nolan. It's something about fix my life.
He wants you to get right to that.
Yeah.
Nolan!
Then he went right into DJ to DJ. Okay. Yeah.
Nolan! Come here.
He went right into DJ to DJ asking you to give your basketball analysis.
So finals. What he did.
That's
okay.
What that was.
So here we go.
That's pretty much the rest of the day.
Okay,
thing.
Double entendre, triple entendre, big word, oh, big word.
Here we go.
Right. So what DJ did, what he did was, he was like, so DJ was like, tell me what happened. Clearly, I didn't watch every game, so I'm not taking notes and write down. I answered the question honestly. What do you want me to say? I mean, they lost.
They wanted your breakdown.
They wanted my breakdown.
Because you do profess to be a purveyor of the game.
All right. See, the purveyor of the game?
Yeah.
And you
watch it different than
I do.
People.
Without any doubt, I have more knowledge than DJ to DJ when it comes to sports. Without a doubt.
Okay. Well, that was put into question.
No. So
that was put into question.
I'm going to give you an example. What DJ to DJ does, he'll go on his show. He'll say something that only he knows the answer to, that he already know, or maybe he already knows the answer to. He'll say something to him, be like, spell it. If I tell you some shit about sports, and I mean, you watch it, you like it.
Yeah.
Some of the nuances, you like, fuck all that. Yeah, I just want to watch the game and enjoy myself.
Right.
And I say, well, tell me what happened. nigga. Nigga, I'm watching the game. So DJ makes a phone call and says, tell me what happened. Nigga, come on, son. Like, you, now, if you want to go there, we can go there. But by no means will you tell me that DJ, the DJ, knows more about sports than me. I would even say, while you trying to show me up, that DJ does not know. DJ is a fan of basketball. I would say DJ does not know. He does not know as much as he claims to know about basketball. DJ, the DJ, oversells and underperforms because
then you finish the rest of the shit.
Right. If you're slow, somebody like DJ can talk past you and leave you scratching your head. Okay. But if you up to DJ on like when his DJ isms, you can catch it like, man, you kind of really full of shit. You just kind of talking, saying some bullshit that just is some bullshit. You know what I'm saying?
He was on his rappity rap.
Right.
All right.
So. He just made a statement, and just like I
sound like Fluh Leon agree with DJ.
Yeah, I think he's trying to take a shot.
So
I give you an example. Like a DJ will say that
I like how, see this here what happened just here is Fluh Leon did a Don King right now.
Yeah,
he ain't got you shooting at him. He got you shooting at DJ.
Exactly.
That's exactly what's going on.
Anyway.
All right.
So, because I don't want DJ.
Only in America.
I don't want DJ to listen and be full of himself because he didn't. DJ isn't me. Let's get that shit very clear. So, DJ will say Babyface is the best producer or songwriter in music.
Wrote a bunch of hits.
Bunch of hits. I know that. Do you know that?
Yeah, I do know that.
He's waiting on an argument to that because he has his shit packed and ready in his backpack.
I don't think nobody was ready to argue that.
Nobody argues it, but he will say it because he wants you to argue. He wants the argument so he can say, aha.
He wants the aha moment. Well, nothing wrong with that.
No. See, if you're slow, you can get caught up in that. And the DJ isn't what make you think he's smarter than he actually is. If all the dumb shit that he said, That's some dumb shit because, right? You're selling what wolf tickets.
I gotta step in for a second here.
Okay,
because
no, hold on. Now, I will say this. Now DJ is,
God damn it, oh, that happened.
Yeah, he is a smart guy. Let me not say that he's stupid.
I was gonna say dumbass,
and I think he's pretty much no.
I want to say that DJ does say some things that. If we were in mixed company,
yeah,
and you kind of know somebody ain't, you know, the sharpest knife in the drawer,
yeah,
they probably don't catch up with him,
right?
You know, we just happen to be some sharp knives. That's all,
exactly.
So we can catch it,
yeah.
So I just want to say that part because it ain't that he's dumb and faking being smart.
No, not by no means.
It's not.
I would say that he is definitely a smart guy.
Yeah.
Now this aura or this fiction that he's the smartest guy in the room is definitely way out of left field.
Yeah, you definitely got an issue with that.
Because you're not finna. I will say that he definitely tried to prove that he's the smartest guy in the room, and I can see how through that.
Yeah.
You can double entendre, triple entendre with somebody else.
Hey, man, you had to find something else.
No, I don't.
Yeah, okay.
That is exactly
that is your go to.
That exactly sums up his ism.
That entendre thing is your go to.
Because, listen. Hey, even dog, listen.
It ain't all about entendres all the time.
No. But Rand and Jay Young will be like, if you listen to their show, they'll be like, nah, nigga. Then you know what he'll do? He'll say, No. This is what I'm saying. No, that's not what you said. What you said was the dumb shit. And you got kind of, yeah, he trying to fix it.
Okay.
All right. 549-825 cell phone today. 549-825 shot. Shout out to DJ the DJ.
Shout out to Fluh Leon because
he's the smartest guy in the room. That is DJ the DJ.
Reese is in his bag right now. And I don't know if y'all can know this, but he is where he was.
No.
When he showed up at my crib.
Not even. Well.
And I am the opposite of what I was when I bumped my head.
I did knock my drink over.
Yeah, that happened. I wasn't even pointing that out.
Shout out to the Sheriff. All right, man. So moving along here on the Shoot From the Hip show. The face aging app, like you talked to earlier, a lot of celebrities were posting their aging pics.
A lot of like, it took over, man.
It did.
You know what? You know.
But I mean,
it's,
so
it's fun at first.
It is,
but then it becomes a narcissistic thing.
That's let me get some.
Let me see what I look like, and let me post what I look like.
I posted. I didn't post. I saw.
I didn't
it,
post
like,
it either. I looked at myself.
Did you see
like,
that?
Hell yeah! I was like, oh,
nah, hell yeah, no.
I'm not. I'm not joining this one. What I tried to do was our you know, cover page.
Well, what I was gonna do was
I tried to do that last night, but they don't want to let me do one face.
Yours?
Yeah, or whatever one I pick, because I did both of them.
Why you can't do two?
I don't know, because I've seen two, but for whatever reason I couldn't do two at that time.
Because I thought about it,
and I was like,
I thought about us
if
doing
we were,
it.
If we were in early on it. Then yeah, but we were kind of late.
Man, you still got time.
Nah, I don't want to be late on the challenge train.
On the ding,
yeah,
ding,
yeah, that there. Nah, man, I don't want to do it. But it was funny.
Yeah,
to see what your mic looked like when you're old.
Yeah, nah, nigga, that shit was tragic. That shit was tragic. I'm like, crazy, nigga, man. Come on, man. Nigga, I'm 40 and I don't look that goddamn bad.
That's right.
I like my young.
I
like
know
my,
people our hey, age.
My young
like
pictures
that.
Had was dope, nigga. I had an edge up and everything, nigga. I had a. All right, you want to go to Fluh Leon or you want to go to Nipsey?
No, man, we got to keep doing Nipsey.
Nigga, it's news.
Let's go.
What's fuckery?
Let's go to Fluh Leon.
All right, there you go.
I had a name for him. I just forgot.
Fliggity, nigga.
No. Flig CBD.
Oh yeah, you got it.
No, I'm not doing that because I'm poking my nose in family business, and I want them in charge me.
Hey man,
up, man.
Look here, dog. Hey, fuck we got this homeboy named Bo.
Okay. So, hey, Reese just took his headphones off. Is shit finna go down? I just want y'all to know.
Have you ever noticed he walked like this?
You talking about? You talking about? Okay.
So I don't know. He's like.
We was
in high school, like I ain't
fucked. Man, look here. This ain't right. This ain't right. Look, see, and I'm laughing, and I don't even know what I'm laughing at. This ain't cool. Hey man, next time you call in, you make sure you flame your brother after this.
Shit. Hey, man. That shit
I didn't participate.
Man, I remember certain shit and it just funny to me.
Oh, apparently, because, nigga, I was not joining in. Nope. Let's go to this last voicemail while we talking about it.
Shit.
Fuck
son.
That.
Hey, nigga, take that shit out.
Hey, man. I love you guys, man. Talk to funny at dinner table. Hey,
good work,
man.
Yeah, man. So
what even did he fucking say on that?
Man, nothing. It was 17 seconds of him rambling on that one.
All right, nigga.
You know, but I'm not shooting at him.
No?
At all, because I don't want to catch myself putting my nose
catch
in the family business. No, I don't want that man be hitting me, man. All
right.
No.
All right, so let's talk to Nipsey. All right, so apparently... Shit, I get my shit together around here. I'm not knocking on the head.
What Nipsey do now? Nigga, you posted that pic on our Instagram page at the basketball court. Oh, that got a little run. That got some run, dog.
All right, so.
That's the shit I
apparently, Nipsey also was under investigation by the LAPD.
No shit.
Yeah, without a doubt. I'm not surprised. They praised him after his death. I think they praised him because they had to. But the strip center that housed his store was a hub for gang activity and the type of violence that apparently took his life. Before he bought the property, the city of L.A. was pressuring the landlord to evict Nipsey.
Whoa.
In his marathon store.
You see how the truth come out after the fact?
Yeah. Now his business partner is still under investigation.
He had a business partner?
Well, investors.
Oh, see. Here we go.
So you think he was really not the owner and maybe just the face?
It's the Suge Knight effect. Here it go.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was the face because he's from the hood.
Yeah.
But he got business investors, partners.
criminal.
Hey, man, look here, man. Dog, we want to uplift the dead. We always want to do that.
I know.
What you never want to do is talk bad about the dead.
Well, I don't give a fuck.
I don't either.
Okay. Let's get this shit clear.
Let's be clear, dog. All that marathon shit, like for real, nigga get shot in front of the store. Like, you don't think it was fuck shit going on there?
Well, to me, because the thing that killed me is that double entendre, triple entendre, big word.
Here you go.
Is that
shout out to DJ the DJ.
Shout out to DJ
You can't help yourself.
Shout out to Paint Pal. He was supposed to meet with the chief of the LAPD to talk about bridging it. Whatever.
We want to have a conversation.
Homie. That's snitching to me.
Like, no, that's not snitching.
Nigga, you
no.
talking to the fucking police, dog. That's
man,
snitching,
trying
dog.
To better your community. That's no, not snitching. He, well, what you thought?
If you trying to okay, if you trying to better your community when shitty cuz came through.
Shitty cuz.
There you go, nigga. Roll call. When shitty cuz came through, you should embrace the homie. When shitty cuz roll up on the set, no. You should embrace the homie.
Sometimes it's just fuck niggas don't need to be around you.
You hating on shitty cuz?
Yeah, get shitty cuz away from me.
Well, shitty cuz still alive.
Okay, well, he won.
Get a gunshot for shitty cuz.
That part.
Shout out for living. Because if shitty cuz and get
shitty
him.
Cuz.
If shitty cuz and get nipped, somebody gonna get shitty cuz.
Whoop de whoop.
Because he was snitching.
Man, look at man. Like, you know, I'm all for the jokes about the whole Nipsey, like people like revering this guy all of a sudden.
Yeah.
I'm all for the jokes on that. But we not gonna give shitty cuz props, man.
No?
No, he don't deserve no props.
Shitty cuz is a martyr.
Hey man, Donald Trump paid shitty cuz.
And that would be a good conspiracy theory to run with.
To office.
You know how dope that would be?
It's probably true.
You think? Come on, man. Nipsey wasn't that big of a threat.
I see Nipsey. He's owning a strip center. We need somebody to off him.
Hey, man. Listen.
I heard Shitty Cuz is excellent. He's outstanding. He's great.
Yeah.
Let's get Shitty Cuz. Let's get Shitty Cuz off. Oh man,
you talking
this,
about me?
This is how we lost Jaquan. I'm for real though, man. Like all this shit is really bullshit. The whole Nipsey revering thing we doing.
Yeah.
That's bullshit. Bushwick Bill died.
Yeah.
And we got like 3 days of it.
Yeah.
Nipsey still getting run.
And Nipsey was that guy though.
Nah, fuck that.
I tell you how they run it with Bushwick. He wasn't shit. I'm just saying. I'm like Willie D. Fuck this nigga.
Hey man.
Fuck this nigga.
Man, Willie D.
Nipsey Search even said this nigga wasn't shit.
Yeah, there's a lot of that. There's a lot of that.
Okay.
But Nipsey slapped a nigga outside the dog on the award show.
He did. I brought that up on the show.
I remember that.
Purposely.
And I remember like,
who goes around slapping people? If the security guard that's probably making no more than $12 an hour, he's only doing his job. Can you imagine? Now, just imagine if that security guard does not do his job. Because
like,
nigga,
you buy a shirt from my store, nigga.
Yeah, and you slapped the
nigga.
Like
no, well, nigga, fuck you, nigga. Whoop whoop.
That who? What kind of dude that's revered in the hood or trying to bridge the gap between the community and the police? Go slap a security guard. They trying to do their job.
They really shut up about that slap after he got.
I know,
killed.
Right?
It was convenient.
I bet that nigga that got slapped don't give a fuck.
I bet he don't. Man, fuck that nigga Chauncey.
Hey, man, shout out to, what's the homie name, man, that don't fuck with it? You think he still fuck with
Jaquan?
That, oh, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, because he was mad about this.
That nigga was mad
shit.
About that shit Nipsey.
Yeah,
he's
like, y'all niggas giggling too much about this Nipsey shit.
Well, you better hope don't no more shit drop, because I'm going.
Tell you what, man.
Nah, fuck that. Fuck that, Jaquan. Man, dog, you better keep fucking with us, nigga. Fuck that.
Like,
because what he said was, he said, I've been fucking with y'all niggas from day one.
Yeah.
So, nigga, because the Nipsey nigga you ain't never met, you gonna start fucking with the Shoot from the Hip show? Nigga, D Montoyis, D Reese? Come on, man.
We know where we at. But y'all ain't got love for us? What? The Instagram streets ain't got love for the Shoot for the Hip show? Fuck that. We know where we at.
You goddamn right.
Y'all want somebody dancing all in your video?
Falling on the driveway?
See, now that's fucked up. Yo, we are really tripping now. And it's 30, well, it's an hour and 30 something minutes in, dog. All
right, nigga.
You don't got to edit this shit.
Nigga, that's what you like doing, so stop.
Well, I enjoy it when it's
double entendre, triple entendre, big word. Here nigga, we here, nigga. Shout out to Paint Pat.
You funny with that.
Shout out to Jay Young. Hey, listen, Jay Young is a friend of the show. I need all of y'all.
And my first cousin.
Right. Y'all need to go to YouTube, to Google, and whatever. Search Iran for the Bloodline album.
Yeah.
But search, go to YouTube and search Jay Young, J.A.Y. Young.
And if you give a damn about lyricism and hip hop, and if you're from the South and you like a Southern nigga rapping about some shit, that's who you need to be.
Hey, y'all need to fuck him for real. Now, yeah. I'll bullshit aside.
Y'all need to be listening to that.
Y'all need to check that boy out, man. That boy,
he rapping circles around your favorite rapper right now.
Big time. So, man, we done had him in here. He fucked with the show. So, y'all need to fuck with him and get that boy his props and his praises while he's still here.
Why his flowers?
Yeah.
What? I said it wrong.
You did.
You want to give him his flowers while he's still living.
There you go. All right.
Praise God. Amen.
Shoot from the hill one@gmail.com is the email if you want to send us an email. We're going to get ready to close this thing out. But before we do, let's talk about Cardi B versus Jermain Dupri.
Bitch. You got to bring some Cardi in here, don't you?
I don't fuck with Cardi like that. But now,
you fuck with Cardi on some fuck shit.
I do. On the shit I just seen.
Because you like the video. Oh, okay. All right.
She is Dominican. All right, so Jermain Dupri said,
"Turn to your neighbor."
Well,
yeah, all right.
All right, so
this was controversial.
What female rappers they are? It is. What female rappers are doing now? He's not impressed. It's called stripper rapping.
Yeah,
yeah. So social media chimed in and said, "Men have been talking about the same thing for years: money, sex, and drugs, or money, bitches, and drugs."
That's the first thing I thought when I heard JD say that.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he still wasn't wrong about
he
the
wasn't
chicks.
Wrong at all.
I don't give a damn. You can point the finger every which way you want to, but the question was posed to him by the lady rappers.
Yeah,
and he just put it out there, and y'all couldn't find a lie in it
by one of the dopest motherfuckers in the music industry. Yeah, fuck what you're talking about.
Who've had female lyricists in his camp.
Well, and
that was killing the game.
If anybody should have said it, he should have said it.
Damn right.
You goddamn right.
And then
double entendre, triple entendre, big word. You know what I'm saying?
Nigga, I swear we're gonna name this episode that or something similar.
Okay, I'm just saying. Because
you like to wear that out. But JD wasn't wrong, man. Yes, yeah, dudes rap about money, dope, sex, all that. All right. But you can choose to fuck with that or don't fuck with it. But if you're gonna ask him, like, what are female rappers doing? They rap about the sex shit. The drug. I said this shit about Meg Thee Stallion.
They gotta pop that pussy.
I said this shit about Meg Thee Stallion.
They don't live the shit they talking. If you talking about riding dick, you need to be riding a lot of dicks around this bitch.
Yeah, they probably do.
Meg? Who she riding?
I don't
know.
She
fucking with Chris Brown
She ain't on the videos doing it. But I'm just saying.
You think she fucking the owner of the record label?
You're jumping off the rail.
Okay.
A little bit. But yeah, man, all the prominent female rappers right now.
Yeah.
They rap about sex.
Got to.
What I do to a nigga, this and that. And I said this. I said this about Meg Thee Stallion. Like, hey, I hope this shit work out for you.
Yeah.
But you better have another plan after this.
Mm.
Because that shit you talking about.
Ain't gonna last.
You saw the City Girls fall off.
City Girls.
Hey, boy, the Reese was pushing City Girls.
Hey.
Well, it's that season. Remember that?
It's that season, baby.
He was killing me with that.
Listen, if we can embrace the dumbass clutch that is Cardi B, that DJ the DJ prayed is so hard, double entendre, triple entendre, big word. Then I believe that we should be praising the City Girls. They black and they doing the same thing. Okay, all right. Come on, Nola. Come here. say this is the Shoot for the Hip Show.
This is the Shoot from the Hip Show. All
right. You want to keep going or we done?
We done.
All right. It's that. Deuce out the roof. Deuce out the roof. Deuce out the roof. Deuce out the roof. Hip time, come on. Northside, come on. Come on. Eastside, come on. Come on. Southside, come on. Southwestside, come on. Most city, come on. What eighth time, come on. What bed time, come on. What VA, come on. What Phil Ward, what Bone Hard, Ross Ness, no stress. I'm talking about.